Howdy y'all, it's Jordan Smith. This is an Anderson 100 window, and this is a hole that a rock from over there put in it when it came flying through and landed in our bedroom over there. So we're closing tomorrow. Everything goes right, we're closing tomorrow on this property, but before we can close, obviously we need to fix this window, so I figured I would film it and show you how to replace a fixed pane on an Anderson 100 window. It's a very similar process to most other windows, so you can apply it to a lot of other windows, vinyl, fiberglass, etc. So first, quickly, tools. I have some masking tape for a couple of different reasons. I have a screwdriver for a couple different reasons. This one specifically though has a soft rubber handle, and I use this for pushing in, which we'll see later. You can also use a mallet instead. I don't like banging on a window with a mallet so much, so I use my body weight with this. I'll show you how to do that, but you could use a mallet instead. I've got a glazier tool right here. It's just a scraper and a pry bar, a couple of different tools on it for glazing. I've got a couple of different razor blades. I've got the small little Ulfa 9mm. I use this to cut away the silicone when I'm removing the window. And I also have the Quick Draw XLR. This is a really cool knife. If you like to have a razor blade that you keep on yourself in your pocket, this is nice because it fits just like a standard little razor blade, like you see any of the other pocket mounted razor blades, really short. But what's really cool about this one, press this button right here, and now I've got a full handle behind it, so I'm able to use it as a full handled, I've got spider webs all over me from cleaning it off. I'm able to use it as a full handled razor blade as well. The blade changes super easily. Press this button here, pops right out. There's no need for a separate tool, a screwdriver to take it apart. Really cool razor blade. They don't sponsor me, so everybody's always skeptical when people are recommending tools. It's like, well, yeah, they're paying you for that. They didn't pay me for this. I just like this tool. It's got a couple of different things for wire stripping. Like it, go check it out. It's called a Quick Draw XLR. All right, so to get right into it, tip number one, I'm starting off right with a tip. Tip number one, silicone. You also need silicone, and you'll need a applicator here. Silicone is very sticky. Some might even call it tenacious. I wouldn't, but some people might call it tenacious. So step number one, I'm going to tape off the inside, because when I put this on, when I remove this window and I re-silicone the window opening and I push it in there, silicone will push out into the inside and it's super hard to clean up. So I'm going to give you a quick tip on how to prevent it from causing you issues later. How do I know this? Because I just spent an hour cleaning up a window over there where I didn't do this. I broke two windows here with the same mowing trip. So we did one without doing this thing. On this one, we're going to try it with this quick tip, and I think it's going to make all the difference in the world. So first, I'm going to tape off the outside here. When this window breaks, and it will break as I'm pushing it out because we've already got some broken shards here, it's going to try to spider web there, and we don't want it to all shatter and fall out. So I'm just going to do a couple of quick X's over it to try to hold this window together. Also, you want to get some good gloves. You can use leather gloves, anything that when this glass breaks, you don't cut yourself. But these are puncture and cut resistant gloves here. They're specifically made to prevent getting cut. So they've got some fibers in there that keep the glass from cutting you if you go through. So make sure you wear good gloves when you're working with sharp glass. Let's go inside. All right, so I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to tape the inside so that this thing doesn't shatter and come all apart on us. All right, so now I have got this taped off so that when this cracks as we're pushing it out, the glass doesn't go everywhere. I'm also going to now tape these stiles off so that when I push the new window in against the wet silicone, it doesn't come up around and cause a big mess. Okay, so now I've got this all taped off here. I'm going to go back outside and I'm going to pull off the exterior beads that will open up the window so we can start cutting away the silicone from the inside. Let's go back out. So here's what Anderson ships with the windows to protect it, this piece of cardboard. I put this down here at the bottom, up against the wall, and then it gives something for all of this junk to fall on as we are working. Here are the beads. So step one, if you have everything taped off, go ahead and cut the bead away here. You should really wear safety glasses when you have broken glass. I'm going to use sunglasses, not because I think I'm cool, but because I left my safety glasses back in Austin and I didn't feel like spending $6 on another pair when I've got like 27 pairs sitting around in different toolboxes at the house. So, not ideal, but we're not doing anything that dangerous. Just want to keep the debris out of our eyes. So don't worry about keeping these. Anderson sends the beads with it, new beads with the window. So you're actually destroying this bead as you're cutting it. You're cutting through the silicone that's part of that bead, and you just cut it completely off like that. And it comes off like so. Start with the two sides. Then you've got the two bottoms. Okay, so now we have removed our four beads all the way around, and you see the glass here that is exposed. And the only thing holding this in now is there's a bead of silicone back behind this that's holding it in. So now you go back inside to cut that free, and then we're going to push it back over to the outside. So let's go inside one more time. Okay, so now that we're back inside, I'm gonna cut the silicone bead back here behind the glass. And for that, I'm gonna use a 9mm breakable blade razor blade. This is Ulfa's 9mm there. Now, be careful when you're doing this because this is not supposed to be stuck out a long ways. This is a non-approved use of this, but why I like it is because I've got a bendable blade and I've got that really sharp razor blade. So you could use a bendable knife and do it. I like the razor because it's super sharp. The drawback is that you can snap those blades back in there. So be really careful while you're doing it. Wear your safety glasses. Or if you're really cool like me, wear your sunglasses. Okay, so now that I have got the bead somewhat cut, I've got it cut everywhere except for in the corners. I'm gonna start prying this window out a little bit. Just going down and with my glazer knife and just popping that bead all the way clean, all the way around to remove it. Okay, so now the glass is mostly out and you can see that that one just shattered because we had this big hole in there and it just wasn't coming out without completely splintering. The one that we took out before was fine. It had a little nick in it and it got a little crack in it and it came right out. This one just sort of came from together. So now we're going to go back outside and we're going to clean off all of that glass that's still attached here, as well as the silicone bead before we put the new ones in. Let's go back outside. Okay, so now that I've got the silicone removed, I'm going to dry fit the window. I'm going to put some tape around the inside to keep any silicone from pushing out onto my glass. And then I am going to pull it back out, put a bead of silicone in, install the window, and then install the exterior beads. If you're wondering about which side goes in and which side goes out, there is a laser etched Anderson logo right here that goes to the inside. So this pane goes this direction. Now, once I am back on the inside here, I am going to mask this off on the glass side to keep any silicone from pushing out and getting on the glass. So Veronica's holding it there and I'm gonna dry fit it and mask that off, and then we'll silicone it, put our exterior beads on, and we're done. When you put the silicone on, even though we've masked the window and we've masked the inside steel styles of the window frame, we still wanna keep the silicone from squishing out too much. So put the silicone on the inside. There's a little U-shaped channel in there. Put it on the inside of that U-shaped channel, and then when you put the window on, it'll push into that U-shaped channel because this glass actually goes beyond that U-shaped channel on all sides. So as long as your silicone is is fully continuous around the outside of that U-channel, you'll have good sealing, but you don't have to worry about it squishing into the inside of the window and getting on your glass as much. So now that we've got the silicone bead put on, we are going to insert our window here up against our bottom spacers. And then just press it good and tight up against the silicone inside. Now we're ready to put the new beads on the exterior, and we're done. So when you put these new beads back on, just make sure that you center them up, and then they just press in. I like using this soft-handled screwdriver. You can use a mallet. You can also just push it in with your thumb if you're really strong. But I like having a tool like this to push in. The mallet makes me nervous to be banging away on a window, but you see a lot of professionals do that. You just push it in like that, it sits and it seats, and then you do all four that same way. All right, so now we have new glass in our Anderson 100. I'm going to go ahead and peel the masking off, and that kept all of the silicone from oozing out and getting on the glass, which is very hard to clean up. If you are needing to clean it up, use a 50-50 alcohol water mixture. You also should use this when you're uninstalling the glass too. It helps loosen up the silicone adhesion. Totally forgot about it when I was uninstalling this window and you saw that it just cracked like crazy. So if you're doing this yourself, use the alcohol. It will really help. Comment below with any tips and tricks of your own. If you're a glazing expert, let us know how we could do it better next time. Subscribe if we've earned it. Go follow us over on our social media accounts, and we'll see you next time on Smith House.